Hello and welcome to Talk Time. My guest today is a much talked about Mumbai-based film personality from Assam, Rima Das, who is not just a director, but she's also a producer, she's a screenwriter, she does almost everything on her own, from costume design to set planning to everything. She's in fact a one-man filmmaking army.
গাছত কে উঠিলে তোর হ্যাঁ আটা চলি কাটা হেঁটি বেটি
মোবাইল লাগে
কত গেছিল তামিল কাটাও পারবা নরা
এতে নোৱাৰি নহাৰ কাৰণে গান পানীতে আমাৰ দেউতা মৰিছে
Rima Das, welcome to my show.
Thank you.
Your film, Village Rockstar, is getting rave reviews internationally. Mm-hmm. You are a filmmaker from Assam. You are from Soygaon. That is where Village Rockstar is actually set.
Yeah.
But not many people in Assam know about your movie, I presume. But you are better known internationally. Tell me about Village Rockstar, and I'll also talk about you, how you came into filmmaking a little later.
All right.
But let us talk about your latest film, Village Rockstar.
Okay, Village Rockstars, it just like probably 4 years back.
Yeah.
So when I came to shoot my first film, Man with the Binoculars.
Antardrishti.
Antardrishti, Man with the Binoculars. And during the time I finished my shoot and I was like, it was 2014, I was doing my post-production of my first film. And then like after so many years, because I lived in Mumbai quite a like couple of years. So it was the first time I stayed long in my village. And I had that like again, like I was connecting to my roots.
Yeah.
And I used to roam around in my village most of the time. And there was a local gathering and I saw these amazing children performing with these fake instruments. And
fake instruments?
Yes. Uh-huh. And I was really surprised and amazed by them. And then this idea actually came to my mind. And yes, and most...
They were playing with a fake guitar, fake drums and everything fake.
Yes, yes. Okay. And above everything, like, actually this film, it's kind of a, like, because when you are living in a city, you live a different life, like you live a materialistic life.
Yeah.
And when I was in my village, then I actually realized what I was missing in Mumbai. So it's just such a like I started again discovering the beauty in ordinary things.
Mm-hmm.
And living with these children and villagers, they actually helped me to unlearn.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how it started. Yes.
Now, Rima, you know, you are not a trained filmmaker. You are not a trained cinematographer. You had absolutely no training in the world of cinema or the world of films. You are a student of sociology at Pune University.
Yeah.
The only thing close to films was the Film and Television Institute of India, which was also located in Pune.
Yes.
I mean, why did you decide to go into filmmaking? Was it destiny or how was it?
You can say it is a destiny.
Uh-huh.
Because I knew nothing about cinema and like about filmmaking because my father is a teacher. He is like a founder.
In Choygaon?
Choygaon. He's a founder headmaster.
Yeah.
His name is Bharat Das and he's the founder headmaster in a girls' school.
Yeah.
And so we born and brought up that way only.
Mm-hmm.
My parents, like my mother Joyadas, she also like, you can say like, you can like, she's
just
the first, she's the first business woman in our locality.
Woman.
Yeah,
okay.
She was running a printing press and a bookstore.
Wow.
It's called Beula Printers and Bookstore. So I born and brought up like that, like my parents always wanted to be going.
What was the biggest pull factor?
Actually, from my childhood, I was always interested in dance and acting. In my cotton college days and my school days, I used to participate in plays and dance. I used to be like best bihu dancer, then best actress. So that thing was in me. Like, so when I passed out from, I did my master's from Pune University. So Mumbai was nearby, and I cleared my even NET exam in sociology. So
you could have easily become a professor.
Probably, yes. But I think I was destined to do this. Mm-hmm. So I went to Mumbai just to be an actor. Not even like, I just wanted to learn something about acting. Yeah. Okay. And then I stayed back. And when I started watching world movies, slowly I thought, because I am born and like we grown up watching Bollywood movies. So when I started watching like other movies, like European movies, Iranian movies, then from India, like Satyajit Ray, then Abbas Kiarostami, Ingmar Bergman, then I realized like probably I can also tell story, and like noticed we have, we can
see. So the best place to tell story is your own home,
yes,
or that is your village.
Right.
Now that is, I mean, this is a very interesting story, village rock star, you know, you are basically talking about woman empowerment, because this was this little girl, your protagonist, Dhanu. Dhunu,
yes.
Just a 10-year-old girl who was in the company of boys, who comes into restrictions the moment she attains the age of 11, 12. And this is how you have projected them. And not a single, except for perhaps one, all your characters were absolutely village boys and girls.
Yes.
They were absolutely untrained. Was it a big challenge?
Yeah, it is a big challenge, of course, like, and when I, because I didn't have that fund, I was doing my first film already, so I decided to go alone with the help of one of my cousin, Mallika Das. So doing everything was difficult, of course, but I took that challenge and where, like...
You did the cinematography also yourself.
Yes.
Now, today people go for crowdfunding. But you are one step ahead of that. You did it self-financing. How could you manage? Because you had a very, very small crew. Most of the films were done in natural light because you didn't have a full lighting crew with yourself.
Right.
I mean, and you did the cinematography yourself.
Yes.
Were you worried that how are your frames going to come at the end of the day?
I was not worried, I think.
Okay.
It was a challenge, and I just took it, and worried in the sense, of course, like after sometimes, initially I was worried because I was old with one film.
Yeah.
And in my first film, cinematographer, he was really good, like in that film, he did a really good job.
In The Man with the Binoculars.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that was the reason you have some expectations.
Yeah.
When you keep doing something, I'm in this, doing this creative process, like you always want to break that boundaries, you know, you have your own expectations. So because these two films are kind of a film school for me, I'm experimenting.
Absolutely.
I have nothing to lose.
So because you are not answerable to your producer, you're the producer yourself.
I have complete freedom.
Absolutely. What is the inner message that you want to portray in this through this village rock stars, that movie?
It is a story about hope and positivity.
Yeah.
So my main message is like a possibility to dream whatever background you are, and maybe we are not born as a we maybe have limited resources in life.
Yeah.
But if you have dream, then you can reach your dream.
Goal.
Like
you can achieve your goal.
Achieve your vision. Yes.
Absolutely.
That is the message. It is a simple thing. Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. Simple message there. The village rock stars, Rima, is saying that if you have dreams, you can achieve it. The only thing that is needed is determination. On that note, we shall go for a short break. Now stay on. When I come back, I shall continue my conversation with filmmaker from Assam, Rima Das.